Most people today realize that people from England and people from the United States generally pronounce things differently. You might also realize that originally everyone in the US who speaks English either came from England or learned it from someone who came from England or learned it from someone who learned it from someone who came from England, etc. The original English person in this chain may have lived 500 years ago, but the point remains. So it follows that originally American English was identical to English English, but became different from it over time. Which brings up a rather disturbing question. What if our beloved founding fathers sounded like English people? What if we hadn't made the split by then? It seems a bit silly and vain, but the idea that the Constitution would have been read, "We the people of the United States of America," is just a bit unnerving to us overly nationalistic Americans. But it turns out that the premise of this question is a little bit off. See, it's not the case that a bunch of English people moved to America and slowly started talking differently while the English stayed the same. Yes, at one point the people in England and the people in America spoke the same, but since that time, both dialects have changed a lot. The English spoken when the two were the same would have sounded like a mix between the two modern dialects. Actually, in some ways, both dialects have changed in the same way, so the original would have sounded a bit different from either of them. But the question remains, did the Founding Fathers speak the same way as British people at the time? Well, the truth is it's hard to tell, but written records from the time indicate that the split was in the process of happening during this period. Some people would have talked differently and some wouldn't have. Younger speakers would have tended to speak differently from the English, while older speakers would have tended to stay the same. But there would have been variants in both generations, and even individual people might have shifted in their speech over time. But I'm going to go out on a limb here and assume for the rest of the video that the Founding Fathers spoke the most recent common ancestor of American English and English English, and I admit that this is mostly because I want to show you what that most recent common ancestor would have sounded like, but I think this is pretty plausible. Washington, for instance, was born in 1732, so he would have been learning to talk in the very early stages of the period when the split was first starting. He was a pretty young speaker, so he might have been one of the first to pick up on the split, and he might have picked up on the new American accent at some time later in his life, but he, along with the rest of the Founding Fathers, were relatively upper-class, well-educated, and often made trips over to England, so there's also a good chance that they would have found this new change to be stupid and deliberately attempted to preserve the older accent. So, for the rest of the video, I'm assuming that the language of Washington and the rest of the Founding Fathers was the most recent common ancestor of American English and English English. Now, I want to give you an idea of what this most recent common ancestor would have sounded like, and in order to do that, I need to attempt to mimic an accent that isn't my own. So what I'm doing right now is my best attempt at speaking in received pronunciation, a standard accent of English English, just to give you an idea of how good or bad I am at copying other accents. Yeah, you thought that stupid Cockney thing I did at the beginning of the video was my real British accent, didn't you? Yeah, no. Okay, now I can show you what the Founding Fathers might have sounded like, and just because I need a sample to pick, and because it's the 4th of July, I'll be reading the beginning of the Declaration of Independence in this reconstructed accent. When in the course of human events it becomes necessary for one people to dissolve the political bands which have connected them with another, and to assume among the powers of the earth the separate and equal station to which the laws of nature and of nature's God entitle them, a decent respect to the opinions of mankind requires that they should declare the causes which impel them to the separation. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these rights are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. That to secure these rights, governments are instituted among men, deriving their just powers from the consent of the governed. That whenever any form of government becomes destructive to these ends, it is the right of the people to alter it or to abolish it, and to institute new government, laying its foundations on such principles and organizing its powers in such a form as to them shall seem most likely to affect their safety and happiness. Then they have a big long bullet point list of reasons King George sucks, but more importantly, now you have a pretty good idea of how both the Americans and the English sounded before they split from each other, and therefore a pretty good idea of what most of the Founding Fathers might have actually sounded like. Have a nice 4th of July!